If you want to list FSBOs, the campaign and the strategy you use to pursue them makes a huge difference on your success. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how to create a campaign that works and converts and gets you results. But before I start, please do me a huge favor and like this video, subscribe, and turn on notifications to get more videos like this. With over a million agents in the industry, standing out and getting FSBOs to list with you is a huge job. There are a lot of agents going after them, calling them, mailing them, and pursuing them to get them to list. So the campaign that you use makes a huge difference on your success. So in this video, I want to talk about how to craft a campaign, give you some examples, show you how to structure it, and tell you a little bit of different ways you can stand out and position yourself so you stand out from all the other agents that are calling the same leads as you, or mailing them or going after them. So the first thing is to stand out, don't blend in. I know that sounds stupidly simple, but when you go after FSBOs, when everyone does one thing, do the opposite. For an example, if everyone mails them letters, mail them a book. If everyone is cold calling them, knock on the door or mail them letters. So whatever they're doing, do something different. If everyone's calling them with a really pushy script, call them with a consultative selling approach. So whatever if everyone's going here, go there. So that's the first thing, is do something different to stand out, because there are so many agents going after them that you don't want to look like everyone else. The different ways that you can stand out are a few things. One is your messaging and the voice, or however you're wording your cold calls, your mail that you're sending out, if you're knocking on the door or you're sending them text messages or emails, what you say makes a huge difference. So if everyone's going after them with pushy sales messages and sales scripts, go out with a helpful consultative selling approach. Go out there and provide value. Help them along the way. See where they're stuck and offer some input and build trust and rapport so that it's easy to get the listing when they give up and decide to list with an agent. Another one is your approach. How are you approaching them? Again, if people are mailing letters, mail a book, if you have one. If they're mailing postcard, mail a letter. A letter may be better than a postcard. So whatever they're doing, take a different approach if it's possible. If you want to see how we're soliciting them in the campaign we're using a guide campaign where we send them little helpful guides, take a consultative selling approach, and we mail them a book. Go to authorify.com/FSBO, authorify.com/FSBO. Check out our campaign. I'll break it down and explain it if you want to see how we do it. Another one is the method that you use. If you're calling them, emailing them, or dropping by, if you change that up and you, let's say if everyone's mailing a postcard, mail letters. If everyone's mailing postcards and letters, mail a book. The other method to do that is to change up the method. So if instead of just going after them with mail, make some phone calls in addition to that. Text them, email them, pull their email from Zillow or Craigslist or the For Sale by Owner website and start sending emails to them and create an email conversation. So if you can do different methods, and I'll show you this here, is if you lay out your campaign, you want to make sure you use multiple steps, and if it's possible, change them up. So here's an example. On day one, as soon as that FSBO comes on the market, my recommendation would be send them a letter, a postcard, or a book, or drop by, whatever you can. Obviously, if you have more money than time, I would definitely go with a book or mail or a letter or something that's going to make them just really pop and stand out. Kind of like a shock and awe package. If everyone sends them a postcard, I want to send them a pile of ideas and good stuff. So that's why something like a book is powerful. On day four, you could call them. You could leave a voicemail if they don't answer. You could send them an email, or you could even send them a text message. Now, there's obviously the do not call list and different laws around that, so it's up to you to do the research for your area and figure out what makes the most sense for you. So with day five, if depending upon how that call or voicemail or email goes, if you don't reach them, I recommend you mail them again. And what we like to do is we like to mail them a guide that shows them how they can do something their own, or how they can market their home, or how they can get top dollar for their home, etc. And after that, we wait a few days. and we call them again. Or if they're doing an open house, go out to their open house and introduce yourself using the script we talked about in some of the other videos on this channel. And then if they don't respond to that, or maybe they're not home or they don't answer the door, maybe you could leave something on the door like a handwritten note if you're knocking on the door, you could mail them again and send them another guide. And you just repeat that, go down the line. The more you can do to show up and stay in front of them and provide value, whether you're using pushy sales scripts or a consultative selling sales script, which is what we love and do here the most. Don't just stop with one step. There are stats out there that prove that if you go out and blow and go and you send one piece and then you just give up, it's way better to solicit less leads and do a better job and have a quality campaign than just to send a bunch of sporadic mail all over the place. So if you have to pick one lead source like FSBOs or Expires and then do a really good job and do a multi-step campaign that uses different steps and different methods. If you have to and you're out of time, I recommend at least doing mail because it's leverageable. Every day that piece can show up, it can be persuasive, it can help build a relationship with them. Calls and voicemails and emails obviously take more time than money. So the more you can do, obviously even doing something like stopping by, that can be a pain in the butt, it takes a lot of time. But open houses on the weekend are a really good way that you know they're home, they're already expecting people to walk in the front door. So if you can look at all the leads you're going after and you're running through your campaign and you can pull them up every weekend and say, are any of these doing an open house? Okay, I'm gonna stop by. And three of them are, one of them are. Go out and get coffee and go by their house and introduce yourself. There's another video where we talk about that. And get the business. It's pretty straightforward. So these are some ideas, some different things that we've spent a lot of time doing. If you want to see how we do it, go to thorify.com/FSBO and we'll break our whole campaign down for you. And if you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications to get more videos like this. Thanks for watching.